Now comes the way of return. Dante went through the three worlds, but came back and wrote about it. If this has been the mode of achievement, we will have flight, what's called the magic flight. Or we may have a return that is protected by the powers. Return comes through until finally we get to the threshold again, back to the light world, and you're out.
In all of these journeys of mythology, there's a place everyone wishes to find. What is it? The Buddhists talk of nirvana. Jesus talks of peace. There's a place of rest and repose. Is that typical of the hero's journey? That there's a place to find?
That's a place in yourself.
Big stuff.
I'm back because of the experiment.
The Oracle prophesized his return.
Hey, I'm back.
The return of...
But I'm back.
Okay. I'm back.
I'm back.
Hey, I'm back.
Mr. Lonely.
He will return tonight.
I'm back.
So many different angles,
there is this urgent feeling that I must improve me.
Thank you. get that real hell, real hell out there. Real hell. Thank you.
radical change of consciousness with regard to one's own existence.
trying to understand the world purely by thinking about it is as clumsy a process as trying to drink the Pacific Ocean out of a pint beer mug. You can only take it one mug at a time. So in thinking about things, you can only think one thought at a time, one after another, in series. Thinking is a linear process. One thought after another, as we say, you can only think of one thing at a time. Well, that's too slow for understanding anything at all. Much too slow. And our sensory input is much more than any kind of one thing at a time. And we respond with a certain aspect of our minds to the total sensory input that's coming in, only if we are not consciously aware of it. But nevertheless, you're doing it. But what kind of you is this?
Wandering stars, for whom it is preserved, the darkness over. Wandering stars, for whom it is preserved.
Stars, the moon is visible, the darkness, the darkness. apotheosis. When the envelopment of consciousness has been annihilated, then he becomes free of all fear, beyond the reach of change.
But then, miraculously reborn, we are more than we were.
Where the hero realizes that he is the divine being himself.
Final threshold guardian to be passed by the universal hero on his supreme adventure to nirvana.
One time for your mind.
Under the impression that you are just poor little me. To find out who you really are, or what you really are. Behind the mask.
One time for your mind.
Nirvana means, in Sanskrit, blow up.
One time for your mind.
The opposite desire is to breathe in. Now, if you breathe in and hold it, you lose your breath.
Got to know the real meaning of the ill shit.
But if you breathe out, it comes back to you. So the principle here is, if you want life, don't cling to it. Let go.
Got to know the real meaning of the ill shit.
state of your mind. I can feel it.
My mind is correct.
good day.
Good day.
It's
better
a good
physical
day.
Style.
It's a good day.
Hey, Joe. Better physical
it's
style.
It's a good day.
With the good day
it's
style.
It's a good day.
And that fabulous
it's
clothes you
day.
Wear. And the way you weave
it's
your
a
hair.
Good day.
Industrial toxic fumigation, symmetrical color resources on the expressway through your skull piece, that the tethering of the
existing
astrodomes in the form of the cats and the dogs, defogging the mind's eyes view in the never-ending quest for cheddar. Just call me Minnie as the bar rises on the horizon for room service. Nervous inflections and chicks in the metaphysical landscape.
Metaphysical style.
Projection of introspection. Reflective imagery burned into the cornea of interdimensional transglobal marketing schemes. Loop, dreams, culminating of horizontal posturing, intertwined sheet music, epic in proportion, enigmatic implosions, inclusive of the masses, I get metaphysical.
Metaphysical.
It's a good day.
Oh yeah.
It's a good day.
Good day.
Good day.
It's a good day. Miho, H-A-T-O-R
it's a good
to the
day.
I. Yo, Tori.
It's a good day.
Blowing up. Me help. H-A-T-O-R to the I.
Now in this question, can I improve me? There is the obvious difference that if I am in need of improvement, the person who's going to do the improving is the one who needs to be improved.
Align and ready themselves to march. Finally, the melody appeared and performed a dance in front of him.
harmony, melody, harmony, and rhythm. Melody, harmony, and rhythm.
stand at the threshold of fear and an understandable reaction would be to hesitate.
the background and bringing your awareness to your thoughts, letting them come and go on their own, just as you did with sound, back into the present moment, to a sense of stillness and peace.
Let's go on then into our visualization, our imagination. Use your imagination for all it's worth. To think yourself into the fact that this whole sense of importance, of vitality, of aliveness, of being is simply a sudden experience, which was nothing before it started. There will be nothing after it's over.
Thank you. test the flow.
Thank you.
But on the other hand, when you say, well, good gracious, this whole thing is something, isn't it? Then you put yourself into it. You don't stand aside from it any longer. You admit that you too are part of the whole thing. That your ego, yourself, is so inextricably involved with everything that you experience that there really ultimately isn't any difference between the kind of thing that's going on and you.
Thank you. place down by the sea. It ain't much, but it's enough for me.
hallucinating, that he has a delusive sense of his own existence.
We'll be right back. toujours comme ça dans les contes pour enfants. À chaque fois, c'est le loup qui est le méchant.
and a world which is an organism has no boss. Man shall eventually live primarily for the concerns of the brain, that is, for art and science and all forms of culture.
We've got into the habit of thinking of the world as a physical continuum, which is not really a continuum, which is divided into the inert things and the earth things, into the conscious and the unconscious, the living and the dead, the organic and the inorganic. Consciousness is something actually purely mineral and metallic, only it's so complicated, but they're basically minerals. And they're basically machinery. And it's all like that, see? And I say the objection to that point of view is simply that it's a way of looking down your nose at things. In fact, it's an objection. The objection to it is that it's an objection. When you construe the whole universe in an objectionable way, the person who does this is really saying, I want to be miserable. Now you're perfectly entitled to be miserable. Or I want to be realistic and miserable in that sense. And that's perfectly okay if that's the way you want to be. But he has absolutely no right whatsoever to say that his point of view is more valid than ours when we say the opposite. That actually, the universe is a continuum, whatever it is, thusness, and that there's a spectrum in which there are the very conscious things and the only slightly conscious things. But all of it is conscious. But actually, there is simply the stream of what you could call luminous experience. You can take away the word luminous and put the word conscious in its place. So see it again. Your heads, your nervous systems, your eyes, your senses, your bodies. Not as something that encounters the external environment from outside, you all are the external environment. Rather, your heads and eyes and so on are points, you see, put out by the environment as a whole, as a totality. Through which it feels all around like many sensitive hairs, like a sea urchin with all those little spines coming out. And each one of us is one.
And you say, well, where was I? Gee, this is strange. I'm alive. I don't remember where I was before. That's the sensation of coming to birth. And you grow and grow, and you become more familiar with this and more familiar. When you're completely familiar, it goes boop, and you're new all over again. Quite different. We can never believe, you see, when it gets to the point where we know it's about to go boop, we never believe that it will go into life. We always think it's going to go into something dreadful. But you see, once you know, it's going to keep flipping. The only thing is to go with that flip. Do you get ready to go? Are you ready? Well, then you can laugh.
Because you know there's no way out.